In this section, we will now look into backing up one other important component of the PI system, namely PI Asset Framework. The strategy for managing Asset Framework backups is the same as backing up PI Data Archive. OSIsoft recommends that a daily backup of the Asset Framework be performed and that this backup be copied to an external storage drive via a third-party application. It should be mentioned that in terms of PI Asset Framework, all the changes made to the Asset Framework since the original install are contained within a SQL database called PI-FD. Therefore, the PI-FD SQL database is the only file that needs to be backed up. The specific backup mechanism will of course depend upon the PI-AF architecture as well as SQL Server Edition. Now, let's look at the first scenario. In the environment that you currently have, PI Data Archive, PI Asset Framework, and SQL Server are all installed on one machine, namely PI SRV1. You would note, then we took the backup of the PI Data Archive, it also backed up the PI AF SQL database, namely PI FD. Now, if you go to PI SRV1 machine, open up Windows Explorer, and navigate to the F folder drive, you will see a folder which is the PI backup, which is the designated backup for the PI Data Archive. Here, you will see a folder called PI AF, which contains the backup of the PI AFD database, which was performed during the initial PI Data Archive backup. Now, let's see how this was done. Now, if you can navigate to C drive, Program Files, PI PC, AF, SQL, you would note there is a file named afbackup.bat. So in a situation where all three components, namely PI Data Archive, PI Asset Framework, and SQL Server are all installed on the same machine, PI backup script that backs up the PI Data Archive also executes this afbackup.bat script as well. Now, if you open up the script, navigate to the end of the page. Here, you would note the SQL Server instance the AF server is pointing to. In our case, it is mentioned by the dot, which indicates that the instance name of the SQL Server is the name of the machine itself. It should be noted that by default, the script would assume that the default instance of the SQL Server, which the AF server uses, is a SQL Express. So in a situation where you have a different named instance of a SQL server, you would need to update this afbackup.bat script to point to the right SQL server instance. Now, let's assume that the SQL server resides on a different server. In such a case, it is necessary to delegate the responsibility to the SQL Server agent on that SQL Server to perform the necessary backup. Now, let's go ahead and learn how to use the SQL Server to institute this AF SQL database backup. So to do that, open up SQL Server Management Studio. So in our case, we are going to connect to PI SRV1, which is the SQL Server instance which the AF server is using. Click Connect. The first thing which we need to do is to make sure that the SQL Server agent is running. Once it is green, you would be able to expand this one, and you can expand the jobs. Here, you would see the OSIsoft backup PI FD. Right-click and select Properties. Once inside this window, select Steps and click Edit. Here, we have to indicate the path where the PI AF backup needs to be made to. To do that, there is a specific syntax, and we need to basically use the syntax. At output out path is equal to n single quotes, and within the single quotes, the path where we want to store the backups for the PyFD database. So in my case, I have this one. I'm going to just copy this. And within this quotes, I'm going to paste it. And you can acknowledge OK. And OK. Now, let's initiate the backup. So both are green. It is success. Now let's go and verify. So navigate to Windows Explorer, Py Backup, AF, and there it is. It was done at 12:32, and we have the timestamp 12:32.